English cricket's been banking with NatWest for more than 30 years. Now the latest player to make a statement for the national side has taken his cue to look up his local branch in central Manchester. Ahead of this weekend's finals day at Edgbaston, Lancashire's Jos Buttler knows all about the big interest in the T20 Blast.
A bit different being in a bank, but NatWest have been a brilliant sponsor for cricket for a long period of time now, and delighted to go to finals day again, especially in my first year with Lancashire. I've been quite lucky with Somerset. I've been to finals day three times before, so I know what it's about. I've lost two finals, I think, and so hopefully this year I can end up on the winning side. But it's brilliant. It's a brilliant day out. It's usually a bit of a circus with the way it runs and the weather, but it's a great fun day, and hopefully some high quality cricket. We've been really strong in the group stages and managed to sneak through in that quarter final, so everyone will be really excited for Saturday.
How important do you think your experience is in that?
The situation won't really faze me. I quite like that sort of big occasion. There's a lot of experience in the team, but we've had such a strong group stage, won 10 of our games, so everyone will be really confident.
Is it a good thing to be the second semi-final?
If you're second, if you win, then you go straight into the final. However, potentially could be a bit strange to get over the emotions of winning a game and then starting one again straight away. So I'm not sure there's any advantage to playing first or second. And as I think everyone will take a keen interest in watching the first game, obviously see how it pans out, see how the wicket plays, what sort of things have worked for the two teams playing in that first game. And obviously you have to be a bit aware of that first match, because if you do go on and play in the final, you'll be playing one of those two teams.
And possibly the home side as well, so you'll hope for good travelling support.
Yeah, definitely. We'll need to take some good supporters down there, and some loyal Lancashire fans who have turned out throughout the group stages. The crowds have been brilliant at Old Trafford, and hopefully everyone will have a really good day out on Saturday and get behind the team. Adam, isn't it?
It's just there, yeah.
He's in your fantasy team.
He is actually, yeah, it's a good choice really. Midway for the table, so it's worse, it's better, we'll try again next season.
We've got a colleague here that's a Yorkshireman as well, so it's great to be able to rub it into him that we've got a little bit further than what they've got into the competition as well, so it's been good.
The last year or so must have been incredible for you.
It has, yeah. Massive amounts changed for me, from leaving Somerset to come play for Lancashire. I think actually in the reasons I moved have been justified pretty quickly with the chance I've had to play Test cricket this summer. Everything's happened very quickly for me this year. Obviously, I said I moved because I wanted to enhance my international ambitions, and I didn't obviously see it coming to fruition so quickly. But it has, and I'm delighted about that.
What's your best moment in cricket so far?
Test debut. It would have been that my one day innings at Lord's, but Test debut now.
Did you see an overnight change in the way you feel you might have been perceived after that 100 against Sri Lanka?
A little bit. I think it's something I knew I was always capable of. But it was definitely the best I've ever played in my cricket career. And to do it at Lord's in an ODI was really special. It would have been brilliant if I could have got the side over the line as well. That would have been brilliant. But I think it potentially did change people's perceptions, and obviously at a time when things were, in English cricket had been a bit up and down, and people were obviously saying that I should be playing and that sort of stuff. But I think it obviously gave me a lot of confidence. I've been lucky to have a really good start in my Test career as well, and win that series. I'm reasonably pleased with the way I kept wicket and the way I batted. Obviously rode my luck at times, but that's great for me. It's important that I just carry on doing what's worked for me, and over the last 6 to 12 months I feel like I've learned a lot about my game and what works, so it's important to just remember those facts and what's worked, and then even when they get to the tough times, because I'm sure there'll be those times when you lose form, remember what it is that works for me.
What would it mean to you then if you could take this trophy?
I mean, a massive amount. I've actually feel like in my short career so far I've had quite a few hurtful days on finals. I've lost two 2020 finals, lost two CB40 finals when it was that, and then I've also lost a Champions Trophy final, so my record's not very good, but you know, it means a massive amount for me to win my first domestic trophy. 2020 is something I've really enjoyed ever since I started playing it. I think it's a game suited to me in the way I naturally play my cricket. It's a really fun form of the game and one I absolutely love. So I'll be looking to go on Saturday and fingers crossed I can put in a really good performance for Lancashire and help the side win the trophy.